in first grade when we were asked to draw a picture of what we wanted to be when we grew up. And I remember drawing a picture of an astronaut standing on the surface of the moon, the kind of iconic Apollo image in the spacesuit next to the flag on the moon. And that was what I drew then and said I wanted to be an astronaut, and then always said it all the way through since that time. I knew that I was going to be ecstatic being in space. You know, it was my lifelong dream, and I knew that it was going to make me happy. But even I didn't expect how incredible it felt. And I said that a lot to people, that it's even more incredible than I ever imagined. And I really meant it, because I had thought so much about it, and I knew it was going to be the most extraordinary experience of my life. But I wasn't even prepared for how I felt, the level of excitement and just pure joy that I felt all the time in that environment. I really felt like I was home. I felt like that was where I should be. And I don't think I stopped smiling for pretty much the entire 7 months. I would find myself thinking, how can this be real, that I'm floating above the planet and looking down on it? You know, even after 7 months and, you know, knowing what we had done to get there and that I'd really worked for this my entire life, it still is actually hard to convince yourself that it's really happening, which maybe sounds a bit funny, but even after 7 months, it just felt that way looking down on the Earth. Wow, this is real. I'm up here floating above the Earth. When you're in the space station, in the cupola, there are stars all around you, and you can really feel it that way. I think that's a good way to describe it. You feel like it's more three-dimensional and diffuse, and you know, you gaze off into it, and it is really just extraordinary to think about that, to think about that scale, and then look back at the Earth and realize that we're just such a small component of that. This was really what had driven me since I was 5 years old, was what it was going to be like to have that feeling, to look back on the planet and you're not there. That's the place, the one place where everything has happened in your life, everything has happened through the entire history of the human species. Everything you've done, all the places you've been, everything is down there in its entirety, and you're separate from that. It actually does feel different looking at Earth through your visor, just through your helmet visor, versus looking out of the window. I think the colors are even more vibrant, and I think also just mentally, psychologically realizing that, you know, there is nothing between the vacuum of space except for this spacesuit and your visor. There's nothing, you know, between you and it. And you're really out there in your own little mini spacecraft. It has the life support system, everything that you need to be kept alive, and it's just you. And you have this sense of just being by yourself in this environment with your own little life support system. And I love that feeling. I don't know what it is exactly about that, but I feel really kind of peaceful and relaxed in that. And in the spacesuit, you're looking down and seeing the Earth from above, from the outside, with your own human eyes. It changes you as a person. When you look back and you're in this blackness, devoid of any color, the blackness of space, and suddenly there's this brilliant blue glowing marble down there, it's so easy to see from up there that we're all in it together. You know, you don't see those geopolitical boundaries, all of the man-made boundaries that we've imposed upon ourselves as humans. You don't see any of that from space, and you just feel this sense of commonality more, and something that unites us all, and just that we're all human.
Subscribe for more space.